Eight to serve. Lavo.
So here we go. It's a best of five match. First player to win three games and Mima Chan to start with the serves. Love all.
One, zero.
Her service game is incredibly strong. The delivery, the variation in spin, surprise factor super high. Two outright service
zero,
points.
Two.
The only balls that have touched Mima's side of the table so far have been the first bounce of each of her serves. Beautiful angle here, corner to corner. Mima Chan with those flatter backhands. Now, I talked briefly about the surfaces on the racket. If you're newer to table tennis, the pips, the little bumps that look like Legos, they generate less spin. So for Sean Xiaona in black, every shot is going to have less rotation, typically, than the forehand right there, the black side of the racket for Mima Ito. With that side, she can spin the ball very heavily if she wants.
Let
which is why she's serving
three,
with it,
one.
For more control and spin variation on the serve. But when she plays with the red side, the backhand, get ready for Mima punch, that short, fast stroke.
Three, two.
And here a bit of an in-between shot, a little bit of topspin on it as opposed to the Mima punch. Sean Xiaona doing a good job of keeping the ball low and not easy to flat attack. And you can see the variation in the spin here. Mima very versatile with that backhand. Sometimes she spins it, but it's tough for many to know how to counter. So neither player going for the towel at the first towel break. Oh, and burned.
Two, five.
Feet taken out from under. Chase this one to the wide forehand, I dare you. But try and come back. Accepted? No chance. Tight serve from Sean Xiaona to stay within two. Now, in terms of style matchups, both of these players don't have a lot of players currently playing that play their style. So there will be shock factor from both ends. But here it's topspin on the serve. The shovel serve with side spin, that's clear. The question is, how much topspin? And is there even topspin? Every serve, Mima keeps it a guessing game for the receiver. But
four,
fast
six.
Long with top and side spin this time. It's a perfect read from Sean Xiaona. Still very close, trailing by just the right amount to come back at any moment. So still a lot of pressure on the upper seed, Mima Ito. Beautiful flat
five,
hit back
six.
From Sean Xiaona, quick and on top of the table. Both of these players love to crowd the table. Fast reaction time. Not many can rally with Mima Ito the way that Sean Xiaona just has. So 3 points in a row for Sean Xiaona. And as Mima Ito cleans off the top sheet of rubber, when you see players doing that, they're breathing on it just to fog it up. Get a little moisture there to remove the dust so that no dust gets between the rubber and the ball. They have full traction for spin and control. Oh, down the line, smart play, the quick Mima punch on the parallel. It's been tough for her to find holes on the table the way Sean Xiaona's controlled the ball. Hasn't backed up much at all. Even when she steps around Sean Xiaona, it's a very compact stroke. And she quickly gets the feet back into position. Wide serve.
6-8.
This is an unusual placement. Mima Ito's done it a few times, and like anyone else at the top of the game, adapting your game to your opponent is crucial. Against a penhold grip, the short, wide forehand can be a bit of a weakness or a tough spot to cover.
Let 6-8.
Mostly because the players are looking to step around the backhand corner to get their forehand into play more.
7-8.
Not satisfied on the receive, but still a one-point lead. Mima Ito of Japan on screen. Good backspin here. Ito floating it deep on the table. Variation in the amount of backspin here. Just mixing it up constantly. Now a two-point lead and two serves for Mima Ito. The short forehand, she keeps it surprising. Oh, she thought it was game. Wow. Now, normally, if it's later in the match, you'll see a timeout after such confusion just to reset. But not here, not now. Three game points for Mima Ito. The brushing backhand and Sean Xiaonan right there on top of the bounce with the kill shot to save game point. How quickly she comes in after this shot. Just a little height, makes her move and lunges out forward. Serves back with Sean Xiaonan. There it is, the Mima smash on the forehand side. She comes through with the finish, 11-8 for game number one. Arguably the greatest of all time. In the women's game, 7.5 years at world number one. So Sean Xiaonan checks the lights for the high toss serve and gets ready to change the score line here in game number two.
0-1.
Good placement, deep and wide. Mima Ito hitting the corner well. What a turn on the corner. The perfect read. Quick feet. She doesn't leave early, but Sean Xiaonan steps around for that long serve to the backhand corner to punish Ito. Right back into that elbow. Again, with the traditional pen hold grip, the middle is a little bit different because you never turn the racket around fully. Meaning the face of the racket is always out at the opponent, but it's still uncomfortable when it's right on top of the elbow. No backswing. Incredible point. Sean Xiaonan hangs in there for some very difficult balls. There's the Mima smash. Comes back off the net. The fanning backhand with some side spin. And right down the line, short stroke. Ito's stance. She is so ready at all times. Cool look at how high the toss is for the serve of Sean Xiaonan. If you're just joining us and haven't been here for a Sean Xiaonan match before, that high toss, why do they do it? Well, the ball comes into the racket with that much more speed. So you can generate a spinnier serve, faster, more surprising serve, but it takes a lot of practice to control.
Exposing
the wide forehand again. Mima Ito saying, chase this one. Show me some cardio here. I know you've got the experience. Let's see if you've got the lung power as well.
Let 4-3.
Good read on the receive, but the follow-up shot. Again, the variation in rotation from Mima-chan. It's a net ball, but she does a tomahawk chop block, hitting the side of the ball. You would presume there's some underspin on it, but clearly not as much as Sean Xiaonan anticipated. Well, now.
4-5.
It's funny, every time someone's had a net, at least in recent points, the point has gone the other way. Tends to be an advantage that ends up being apologized for or acknowledged. You'll see the players raise a finger as if to say sorry. Ah, taste of her own medicine.
5-0.
Except instead of the wide forehand, like Mima Ito serves to Sean Xiaonan quite a bit, it's a wide serve to the backhand, testing Ito, seeing if she'll step around with a spinny forehand, but leaving the open wide corner. That shot does not come back.
Five.
No returns on this one. Mima-chan, what's the return policy? No, sorry. Final sale right there. There's the acknowledgement
seven.
For the net, but one thing that Mima does really well is that right there. The push before was deep, and then she cuts under the ball, leaving it just behind the net. This is where the fast footwork, it's coming into play. It's where she can take the ball right off the bounce before the ball's risen to keep it low in the push game. Top of the net again.
Five,
they are playing
eight.
A very low trajectory game, these two. As you might have expected with the short pips out for Sean Shauna and the backhand of Mima Ito. It's really just back and forth.
Nine,
I mean, almost
five.
Every point has a net in the middle of it to break the rhythm. And yet still the points continue. Look how low the shot was from Sean Shauna. And Mima Chan keeps that racket face very open, so you can't tell if she's going to push or attack until nearly the moment she contacts the ball.
Let 9-5.
Good pressure to follow up
ten,
the serve. The
five.
Third ball attack sets up 5 game points for Mima Ito of Japan. This time, the net favoring the player who wins the points. Sean Shauna saves game point, serves back on her side should she get through the first. A nice
seven,
depth in the push
ten.
Game. Sean Shauna keeps Mima deep on the table. This has been a key ingredient for those who've gotten through Mima Ito over the recent years. Spinning it deep, keeping her as far back from the table as possible. Elaine Lim, dentist and umpire. Dentistry is just a passion job. And there it is. Mima Chan takes game number two, 11-7. So a 2-0 lead, one game away from moving on. Flattery does not come in a much higher form. 2-0, she leads, and she starts with the serves. Mima Ito.
1-0.
A good kick serve deep to the backhand, fast with side and top spin for the first point. And the flick
zero,
is no
two.
Problem. Sean Shauna with an impressive receive here. She's taking her chances. She goes wide. Mima Ito is not known for her wingspan, but the fast feet get her to the corner for the counter win. Look at the
zero,
angle here.
Three.
Time out. I would take one. So less smiles and laughter here. Just observation. First point right
eight,
out of the
one.
Timeout in the push game. Conservative play. Cautious play. Much like Ma Long in 2017 saying, I'll let you have the first attack, but make sure you're in position because it's not going to be easy.
4-1.
The way Mima Ito attacks, it's tough to give her the first attack, but if you're very precise in your control game over the table, it could set you up well, and Sean Shauna has shown us that. Or at least
one,
for one
five.
Point since the timeout. But two of the three since the timeout, favoring the player in the lead, the upper seed, Mima-chan.
1-6.
Urban myth, if you hit the ball when it's in the air, doesn't matter if it's already out of play. If it's missed the table already, like just happened, no problem. Now this is good positioning. Sean Shauna gets Mima behind the table by one step, and it's enough to force her to play more cautiously, as you saw. Tried to work her way back in and create an angle.
Let 6-2. 7, 2.
In a deep push that appears to be quite heavy, but overcompensated for by Sean Shauna on the lift. Trying to keep it deep and fast, but these low pushes from Mima Ito don't leave much opportunity for the trajectory that Sean Shauna is playing. And a deep Mima punch to the backhand side. And it is now 8 match points for 21-year-old Mima Ito to move on through to the final 8. Quarterfinals it is. Mima Ito dominates game number 3. The timeout got a quick point, but only one more after that for the rest of the game. 8-7-2 is all that was allowed for the veteran opponent, Sean Shauna.